Common grace may not be the best term to use for what we're discussing here, although it's now become a technical term in theology, so we do use it. I sometimes call it universal mercy or something like that. But what the general meaning of it is that God, by his unmerited favor, extends to all human creatures and really over all creation grace, in that he restrains the effects of sin. He allows for some superficial goodness to happen, even in those who are totally depraved, so that there are acts of goodness or superficial righteousness that a person could do even outside of Christ. That only happens because of God's restraining activity. So in that sense, it's better to call it mercy rather than grace, because grace, I think, is more appropriate in that sense to a redemptive context. But it is common in that it extends over every person. It applies to every person. And it's gracious because God didn't have to do it that way. He chose to do it that way for a number of reasons, but one of which is so that depravity wouldn't take its natural course, which if it did, the world would be in chaos in one sense. So it's gracious in that way. Van Til wants to try to steer a middle way, a third way, we could say, between those who would deny common grace. And his one of the men he interacts with is Herman Hoeksema, on the one hand. And then he's also critical of Abraham Kuyper's view, because he thinks Kuyper's view of common grace allows for a kind of neutral terrain or territory in which believer and unbeliever interact. I think Kuyper's view is the most common view now, probably, in Reformed circles. I think that's unfortunate. Van Til tries to show how, basically, he says, a pox on both your houses. We can't have denial and we can't have neutrality. So his particular understanding of common grace is that God works in history, as he likes to put it. He talks about earlier and later grace. God works in history in such a way as he is as to separate the sheep from the goats, which is the ultimate telos of history in terms of our salvation. So common grace is the means by which God does that.